Hey guys, and welcome back to Field Notes. Now at the beginning of this month, there was a day called National Fossil Day, and that was October 12th. So I am super on my game. Let's check to see when National Fossil Day is next year, shall we? Next year, it is October 11th. So I'm either very unprepared for this year, or I'm just really on top of things for next year. But anyway, every year the National Park Service organizes a big day, basically just celebrating fossils and their stewardship. And honestly, what better way to celebrate and honor fossils than to learn more about them? On this channel, I have done two other videos about fossils, but today we're going to be talking about the fossil record. And the fossil record is basically what it sounds like. It is a record of all of our fossils, but we have put it in order, in a fancy order, so it tells the history of our planet through the fossils that we have collected. Remember that fossils are just physical representations of a life at that point in time. So as you can probably imagine, they're really good at indicating what's going on in the world. Now, one of the main questions asked about the fossil record is it complete? And the short answer is no, and it's doubtful it ever will be. Now, this is the case for several reasons. First of all, I think we need to have a definition of what complete is. What does complete mean? Does that mean that we have a fossil representation of every organism in every variation? Then that's a very tall order when it comes to fossils. We have to remember that the creation of fossils is an unlikely event. The environment and the factors that go into fossilization have to be just right for it to even occur. And even if you do become a fossil, there's a good chance that you're going to be destroyed before a sentient ape evolves and picks you up and decides to categorize you. And lastly, there's an awful lot of geologic strata that we cannot see. It is below us and will likely never reach the surface. So because the fossil record is incomplete, there's always a lot of talk about finding the missing link. And what most people mean by missing link is simply a transitional form between two branches of evolution. One missing link or transitional form is simply going to open the doorway to other transitional forms with smaller changes. It is also important to remember that any transitional species is going to happen in a small population. And if we remember some terminology, then we should remember that the more of you there are, the more likely it is that you will become a fossil. However, there is one story that I wanted to share with you guys about the discovery of a so-called missing link or a transitional form. And that is the transition between a vertebrate that was adapted for land and the ones that were adapted for water. These transitional fossils were discovered by somebody named Neil Shubin in the very northern part of Canada. Shubin's team found a pit of fish skeletons that were so well preserved that they were able to determine that this was the missing link between vertebrates that were adapted for water and those that were adapted for land. They basically split these adaptations right down the middle, so half were very water-based and half were land-based. This was in 2006, and that is like basically an hour ago to geologists. This creature was characterized as a lobe-finned fish, and I would be surprised if you guys haven't heard the name, because the name is Tiktaalik, and I feel like it's such a unique name that we probably remember it when we hear it. Tiktaalik. I love it. It's so fun to say. This wasn't the first Tiktaalik to be found. We found another one in 1998, what we assume now to be a Tiktaalik because it was just a fin and it had finger-like digits forming. So that's how the fossil record helps us determine the evolutionary tree, but it also has very practical uses for geologists. Fossils are excellent age markers for strata. It is much easier to determine the age of a rock if you have a plant or a fish in it that you know couldn't have existed before or after a certain date. The fossil record is also a fabulous indication of climate change. If you are seeing one type of fossil or even a group of fossils and then suddenly they're gone, that is a really good indication that something in their environment has changed. That is the fossil record helping tell Earth's story, incomplete and all. Remember, if you like these videos, make sure to give this a like, hit subscribe if you are not subscribed already to keep experiencing geology. Come back, hang out with us. We've got some really cool stuff coming. I'm really hoping that we can get some of these videos filmed. Ah! Pressure of adulthood. Crushing. Compressing. If you want to share this video with any of your friends, your teachers, anybody you think may enjoy this video, be sure to do so, and I will see you guys very soon with another video. Bye!